today's video, we're going to show you how to paint the red armour of the Evil Sunz clan. Now, the first thing we'll need to do is undercoat the model. And you can see here, I've used Mechanica Standard Grey. This is a nice neutral colour just to make it easier to paint all those other colours. So the colours we'll be using for the red, we'll be starting with Mephiston Red as a base coat. Then we're going to layer all over using Evil Sunz Scarlet. After that, we'll shade in the recesses using Agraxo Shade. And then we'll highlight using Wild Rider Red. And finally, we're going to make some check effects. And we're going to do this in yellow, so we'll be using Avalanche Sunset for this. So the first thing we'll do is put that base coat on. So I'm just going to get some Mephiston Red onto my palette. And then just a touch of water just so it flows a bit nicer, like so. Then we'll just start painting the armour panels. So there's quite a few on this guy. You've got obviously the boss pole at the back there, his jaw, and his shoulder pads. So we're just going to coat all these with Mephiston Red. You might want to put two thin coats on this, but let's see how we go. With that base coat dry, we're now going to put a layer of Evil Sunz Scarlet over, just to really brighten up the red. I'm going to do this all over. It's a full layer, so it's going in the recesses as well. With that layer now applied, we're going to be using Agraxo Shade, and we're going to be running this into the recesses. And also we'll do it around any rivets and other gaps as well. If you do make any mistakes, just use some Evil Sunz Scarlet just to touch up. With that shade now dry, we're going to use Wild Rider Red, and we're going to start edge highlighting all the panels and also picking out any of the rivets as well. For most of this, you can just use the edge of your brush. Some other areas, you just have to get a nice point to it. With the red armour now done, we're going to move on to painting some check details. Now, we're going to be using Avalanche Sunset for this, but you could use white instead, so White Scar. So the first thing we need to do is thin down a little bit of Avalanche Sunset, and then what we're going to do is draw some vertical lines, like so. I'm actually using the little gaps in between the dags at the top of that boss pole. And then we'll need to do some horizontal ones as well. Now, you don't have to worry about being too near, because these are orcs, and we all know orcs aren't renowned for their artistic flair. So if you do make any mistakes, don't worry about it too much. With those lines now drawn, we're going to start filling them in. Now, the first thing we need to do is pick one square, if you like, and we'll fill that in with Avalanche Sunset. So I'm going to do this one in this corner here. And obviously, we do every other one after that on this line. So do that one there, like so, and the one on the end there, like that. Then when you move up to the next line, obviously you don't want to do the same one above it. You want to stagger it like a checkerboard. So we'll do one, that's the second one in. We'll move along. You just keep repeating this. Just make it nice and staggered. And again, if you make any mistakes, just go back over your reds and just make those lines again. And also, it'll be worth doing a couple of coats of this as well, just so it's nice and striking in colour. And there we are with the checks now done. The Evil Sunz armour is completed. Now, when doing any kind of check designs, do have a bit of an experiment on which panels you want to do, but sometimes less is more, so don't overdo it too much. So I hope you've enjoyed this video. Keep sending those requests in, and we'll see you again soon. Bye-bye.